Okay, so we got cyborgs, which are half man, half robot. We got cyborg animals. What about plants? Hey everybody, Trace here reporting for DNews. Bionic plants! Bionic plants. They're a thing and they are coming. Plants clean and revitalize the air for us. They hold soil in place for other plants. They protect wildlife from predators and weather, produce nutrition, and so many other things. But scientists at MIT looked at plants and were like, we can do better. Their experiments with plants involve embedding microscopic engineered materials into the plant fibers. They're so small you can't see them with the naked eye. They're called nanomaterials. These nanomaterials could add to plants' functions and enhance their natural abilities. We totally need a bionic man joke right here. These MIT researchers created a solution of modified negatively charged DNA wrapped nanotube particles. They wrapped those in polyacrylic acid. They added some of this solution to the underside of plant leaves so that they could enter through the leaf's natural pores, called stomata. Remember those? High school bio class, anybody? Once inside the leaves, this acid allows the material to pass through the membranes into the chloroplasts, where chlorophyll lives, to deliver a nano payload. It reminds me of the Terminator. You know, you need that robot surrounded by organic material to get in there. Ugh. Normally, a plant can use only about 10% of the energy that's hitting the leaf, but with the addition of these carbon nanotubes, the leaf can pull in wavelengths normally out of its reach, adding a 49% increase in overall plant electron flow. This is the most basic level of what they've dubbed plant nanobiotics. So, though scientists can make plants do this, they don't actually know what that 49% increase will do to the plant in question. But the possibilities are astounding. With an increase in electron output, we might see plants that can detect contaminants in the water, air, or soil out in the yard or in a forest. You could end up with a fern that enhances your Wi-Fi signal or a tree that pulls in over-the-air television. This is so new, the possibilities are endless. Funnily enough, this technology got its start when researchers were attempting to create a plant-based solar cell. Instead, we just made plants better overall. Who knows where a little science is gonna take you? Think about it for a second and tell us what kind of crazy plant nanobionics you'd wanna create if you could. Share your ideas down in the comments and subscribe for more DNews. Thanks for watching.